This video demonstrates creating stream order numbers with FME. Stream order numbers are a measurement of the branching of streams and tributaries. FME can calculate these as either a Strahler or Horton number using the StreamOrderCalculator Transformer. The first source data set for this example is a 2D hydrological network in Esri shapefile format. The aim is to calculate Strahler order numbers for this network. One requirement for the calculation is an origin point for the network. To obtain this, we'll overlay the stream network on a digital elevation model and extract the node with the lowest elevation. The DEM we'll use is a raster dataset in CDED format. The two datasets have already been reprojected to the same coordinate system and excess attributes removed. Let's start this project using an empty canvas in Workbench. The first task is to add the source data to the translation. So we'll first add a reader for the shape data, and now for the CDED data. I now add a topology builder transformer. This transformer provides us with the nodes we wish to find the network origin point. Now I add the key to this workspace, the stream order calculator transformer. Let's look at this transformer's parameters. Firstly, I set the order type to Strahler. Secondly, because I'm unsure about the source data, I set a parameter to fix the flow direction and ensure all stream features run in the same direction. Now let's deal with the elevation model. I'll obtain elevation for the stream nodes using a point on raster value extractor transformer. This copies the elevation value from the nearest raster cell onto each node point. To find the origin point, the point with the lowest elevation, I'll sort the data by elevation and then select, or sample, the first of those features. In the sorter parameters, I sort by elevation. In the sampler transformer, I keep only the first feature, the feature with the lowest elevation. Now I simply connect that origin point to the stream order calculator and run the workspace. I'm running the workspace with full inspection, so if I want, I can see the results of every step of the translation and don't need to add inspector transformers. Now I open the results in the FME data inspector. Querying a completed network, I can see there is a Strahler order attribute that denotes the position of each stream in the network order. This example was a simple one, including only a single stream network and no lake features. In a more complex example, I would need to remove lake features and use group by settings in the transformers to ensure that each network is operated on separately. Thank you for watching this FME tutorial video. I hope you found it useful.